I woke up at 5:30 a.m. to catch 3 trains, walk 1.2 kilometers, all to meet a stranger. Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to the vlog. Guys, if this is your first time watching and you do enjoy this, consider subscribing below and leave me a comment because I am replying to everyone. And if you've been here before, you know what I'm gonna say by now. Welcome back, legends. And I have absolutely loved your kindness of your comments and chatting to you every week. It's truly what keeps me going and it's the best part of my week, having a chat with y'all. Now in today's video, I've traveled deep into the countryside, 2 hours in fact, to spend the day with a subscriber. Now this is a perfect example of how to make friends in Japan, and we'll go into that a little bit later around how I met him, but for the time being I say let's get out of here.
Taku, what's up?
Guys, we've got a bit of stranger danger here. We are in the Japanese countryside now, about 2 hours away from Fukuoka City, and this place is stunning. Like, just check out the trees behind us here, and this landscape is just beautiful. This is the thing that I kind of miss about living in the city a lot of the times, is coming out to this countryside here, and it's absolutely stunning. But again, I am not alone right now. I am with this fella right here, who I actually met through HelloTalk, and he ended up being a subscriber of my channel. And I had this wild idea that I wanted to spend the day with a subscriber, and he's absolutely amazing guy. I've had a couple minutes with him so far, but we're gonna ask him a couple of questions about who he is and guess what he's doing here in the Japanese countryside. That cool?
Totally cool.
Awesome, man. Let's jump into it. Do you mind introducing yourself to the people watching?
Not at all. So my name is Taku and I'm from Kita Kyushu, but now I live in Nukiha City and I'm 26 years old and I enjoy my life here.
Awesome, brother. That's what we love hearing. Mate, I have to say, and this is one thing that I picked up straight away from you, is that your English is phenomenal, which is very rare in Japan. How did you learn English?
So I went to a language school in Fukuoka and I learned English for 2 years. And then after that, I went to a university in Wisconsin.
Oh, wow. And when you learned English for 2 years, was it at this level right now?
I don't think so.
You picked it up more in Wisconsin?
Right. I think I got dialect as well and a lot of slangs. And I've been a little bit Americanized in Wisconsin.
You definitely got the American accent to it, I can hear.
Exactly, yeah.
Now, you said you lived in Wisconsin. How was your experience living overseas? Was there any challenges?
I did enjoy living there, but one thing I was struggling with was making friends.
I completely feel that right now for me.
Because of the language barrier and cultural difference.
Was there a different approach that you tried to making friends there? Anything that can help people, I guess, being in any new city, making friends, even myself?
Right. I listen to songs that local people listen to so that I can make a conversation with them. And also I've watched tons of Netflix movies and dramas to immerse myself in the culture.
Ah, so you kind of had a lot of talking points there, right, when approaching people or being approached in return.
Yeah, exactly.
I feel like if for me being here in Japan, a lot of the time people want to chat to me about anime, and full disclosure, I don't watch anime, but that would help a lot of my conversations here. So I'll get some tips from you later.
Yep, I can help you with that.
Thank you, sir. Is there anything that you miss about living in Wisconsin, actually?
Definitely friends. I haven't seen them for a while and I definitely miss them. And also Pop-Tarts.
Pop-Tarts?
Pop-Tarts and other American unhealthy snacks.
Yeah, but they have the best unhealthy snacks, right, I think, right? Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah. And can you explain where we are right now?
So we are in a mountain area in Nukiha City. There's a waterfall site called Chōon no Taki. It's got a cool waterfall and a pond that has a lot of koi fish.
Should we go and check it out and then maybe grab a coffee after?
Absolutely.
Mate, let's do it, champion.
Let's do it.
Let's go. Oh my God, I just had this camera set up and these people thought that we were just driving away without our camera, so we're beeping at us to come pick our camera up.
All right, let's go check out a waterfall. What do you reckon?
Man, this area is amazing. It is very loud out here because of all the cicadas that are out. But check out, first of all, this little spot right here. It's a pool during summer. There's kids kind of coming out here and swimming. But we're going to go this way and check out this waterfall up here. So let's go. Now, I know it's pretty loud here, but I'll try and not do too much talking here. But what you can eat here is somen noodle, which is like a white noodle, which you might have seen in some YouTube videos or TikToks and stuff where they've got noodles floating down a little bamboo chute and you pick out the noodles. Now, Taku just mentioned that this water right here is natural spring water and you can actually drink it. So let's give it a taste. That's delicious, man.
Delicioso.
Oh, shit. It's so hot out here, but the cold air from the waterfall is awesome. We're gonna try and reverse this waterfall. This waterfall is stunning, but it's super loud here. So I say, let's go and get that coffee. What do you reckon?
Let's do it.
All right.
Now, just before we get to coffee, I found this place along the road on the way to coffee and it's too good not to stop and I need to understand what's going on here. Let's go and look at this.
Now, this is a bus stop I just found on the side of the road as we were driving to the coffee shop, but have a look at what is going on here because I can't explain it myself, but come this way and come have a look at some of this stuff here. So these obviously town folk have made these and I've seen these throughout Japan. They've got like hay inside them, I think. And it's a way of filling out like abandoned areas, I imagine. I know that in some areas of Japan, there are abandoned towns and the elderly community in these towns actually make mannequins to populate the areas. And this might be what's gone on here and it might be something fun for the kids, but I'm not sure how fun this is gonna be for the kids, mate, because this is ultra creepy. But I'm saying, I reckon out of probably all of these, I think this one's the coolest, man. Like, they made shades for this legend. Dude, this is too much. Let's go and get that coffee, eh? Let's go.
We just arrived at this awesome little cafe that's local to Taku and his family. They buy coffee from here, but this place is cool, man.
So I've just come up the stairs here, and this is the upstairs area of this cafe. Check out this view. This cafe is beautiful. Full view of the Japanese countryside. So this cafe is called Zerokoba, and it is just stunning. You've got these views out the window here of the Japanese countryside. You've got them doing their own brewing downstairs. And you were saying before that you actually buy your coffee beans here for your coffee shop.
Yep.
That you have your family coffee shop.
For myself as well.
Yeah, that's awesome, man. And actually have ton of different blends that they do here. Probably can't see, but they got coffee here from Colombia, Brazil, Kenya, Ethiopia, cold brews, but it's real specialty coffee, so I can't wait to try it.
So the coffees have arrived, and what coffee did you get? You got Colombian coffee, I got Brazilian. Mm-hmm. Give it a try, champion, see what you think. And the taste test.
So good.
It's good.
So
good.
The difference is too much, man. Let's tuck into some of this, I reckon.
So now that we're having coffee, let's have a little bit of a conversation. What is your favorite part in Japan? And you can't say home, because that's just cheating.
Yeah, I was gonna say home, but
yeah.
My favorite place is definitely Kyoto. I love Arashiyama and going to several kinds of shrines as well.
This area right here, in the city that we're in right now, it kind of really gives me that Kyoto vibe.
Oh, I know what you mean. I know what you mean.
Yeah, it's like the buildings when I first arrived and we're driving down that main street. They're stunning and it's like really old school aesthetic, but it's really clean and really well looked after here as well. So let's keep ducking in some more of this coffee, I reckon.
Mate, I appreciate it, champion. This is a nice spot.
Just a nice coffee.
Yeah, that's good.
Thank you, sir.
It's pretty refreshing.
Mate, I've got energy.
Yeah.
I've got energy. All right, let's go and explore a little bit more, eh? What do you say we go to that shrine?
Let's go.
I forgot how convenient having a car is. I miss having one in Australia. All right, this was the main reason why I wanted to come here and why I got in contact with Taku. And it just so happened that he lived in the same city as this location right here. Now, this place is called the Ukiha Inari Shrine. Is that right, Taku?
Yep.
Yep, awesome. So if you've ever been to Kyoto before and there's the Inari Shrine, this place right here is very similar to that. Now, check out this view. This is stunning. I say we go and do a bit of a walkthrough on this and I'll send the drone up and let's go check it out right now. We made it all the way to the bottom. How many stairs? About 100 plus?
100, like approximately
100. Yeah. Oh my gosh. But the cool thing about it is we get to walk all the way back up. Oh no, mate. Okay, the walk commences, buddy. It's so hot, mate. You're sweating so much, you poor guy. Sorry, buddy. But thanks for driving me to the top.
I'm used to this hotness, so
yeah.
Don't worry about it.
Countryside heat hits just a little bit different, but
it's different.
It's a lot of stairs, but it's worth it. Okay, we just got done with the shrine and now we're out here grabbing some lunch. Where are we going for lunch today, champion?
Going to a Taichoku place. It's like a traditional Japanese food.
Oh, style. Awesome.
It's gonna be really good.
All right, let's go get some food, man. From pitcher to plate. Mate, look at this. That's what I'm talking about, a feast, buddy. Oh, mate, I say we tuck in. Let's go. Tuck in, champion. What do you think, mate? Rating out of 10?
Definitely 11.
11? Yeah, I have to agree.
I'm a bomb. It's so hot. I couldn't bite it in half, so I took the whole piece.
Meal done and dusted, mate. That was delicious, sir. Full? Mate, you got that double helping of rice. Mate, big boy, big place. We're now gonna go out to his actual workplace, which is a family-run company, and it's down by a river. So I'm actually quite excited to go and check that out and hear a little bit about what this company is actually about, mate. And we'll catch you up over there, legends. All right.
All right, and we have just arrived at Taku's place of work, my friend.
Right.
Do you want to explain about what the actual business is here? Because off to my left here is a bit of a couple of farmhouses. It's a fair bit of land, but we also back onto this stunning river. If you want to give us a bit of insight to what this business is all about.
Okay, so we make sausages and bacons and hams inside a factory, and we use pork that we raise. So we raise hogs at the back. Backyard.
Wait, how many hogs do you
have? There's 1,400 hogs right now. Wait, approximately, what? Yeah.
1,400 hogs off to my left.
Right.
Told me a little bit about this earlier, but I didn't realize that it was this large. But I guess in the countryside, this is kind of what people do. They have these more massive land, but you're on a much bigger scale to what I thought.
Yeah, we even deliver to Tokyo and other prefectures like Tottori as well.
So it's not just local community based that you sell your products to. You sell all over Japan these pork products.
Yes.
You're saying before when we were having a little bit of a chat about these communities in the countryside is that everyone kind of needs to be a bit of an entrepreneur. And I hadn't really thought about this before, but everyone kind of has their sources of income coming in, but they need to have multiple sources of income. So this is a perfect example of that where, you know, you have not just a pork company here and they sell their products to the community, but also all over Japan. But you also mentioned that you have a cafe here.
Yeah, we have cafe and we serve hot dogs, coffee and other delicious food at a cafe.
Oh,
you guys
awesome.
Are welcome.
Mate, it's a beautiful area, particularly backing onto this river right here. Oh, what's the name of your cafe here?
So it's called Riverwild.
I'll link it in the description below and I'll link it to the Google link so then you can take a look yourself and see what they do because it looks delicious. This is the part of Japan that not a lot of people get to see. And if you are visiting Japan, I encourage you to jump into the Japanese countryside because it just has an absolutely different vibe. And it's been a great day, mate. So it's been a great day. So thank you
so much.
Thank you very much for showing me around, my friend. Guys, we're gonna leave that here. Until next time, I hope you enjoyed this. Leave me a comment below. Jamata, and I'll see you soon.